remember roll and drop, which 90% of you won't.
Okay then, I got myself a new baby. Yeah, I've been waiting for this. Now, before anyone says what's wrong with you, Ron, there's nothing wrong with me or the kayak, right? It's just a case of, and I suppose if you're more interested, I can go into more detail in another video. But if you watch my River Old video, I just went up to Tickton and it was a mile and a half, that's all. But with a headwind coming back, I mean, it killed me. It was so hard because you kept getting blown back because it was such a light little inflatable. Whereas this is more of a professional inflatable. Now, I'll tell you one thing right from the start, right? It's the Itiwit X500, right? But I'll tell you one thing, it comes with your real nice shoulder straps and a harness right at the bottom, which you might not be able to see from there. Right? It's got your stomach harness, a chest harness, your shoulder straps, so you can whack it on and carry it. Well, I'll tell you right now, right? I'm quite fit for my age. Nearly 60. I'm quite fit for my age, but there's no way I could get this on my back from the ground. If it was up high and I could sort of like step into it, yes. But from the ground, there's no way I could lift that up and get that on my shoulders. Impossible. Maybe a 40, 30 year old guy could do it, but from the ground, there's no way. This thing is heavy. And there's just no way I could lift that up. Right, so anyway, apart from that, which isn't really a major problem because my other one was just a carry one, so I just have to carry this to the car and get it out of the car, you know what I mean? So it's no big problem. So let's open it up and then I can tell you a little bit more about it as I put it together. Now I'm gonna have to do some fancy editing in the next room because it's a dark room and it's the only room long enough for this to fit. Okay. Oh, I will mention while we're here, before we start, we've got a really good pump with it. Really good pump. Right. It's got two settings. Right. The first setting will only take you up to 8 psi. I'm out of shot. First second, take you up to 8 psi. But for this particular kayak, you just want it on number two, which will take you all the way up to 20 psi, but this is just 10 psi in all five chambers. But like I said, I'll explain a bit more of that when we open it. Oh, but just to give an idea of how high this, that's from the floor now, that's touching the floor, I'm stood up straight. So that's a good 3 foot. So you're not like bending down, going like that, you know what I mean? You've got a good up and down motion. If I go from the side, so you're hardly bending your back. Not like some weight, where you're like that for half an hour. Anyway, right, let's get this thing unpacked, pulled out, and give you a closer look. And if there's anything interesting, I'll tell you. Okay then. Jump shot. Oh, if anyone's interested why that green screen's there, the plan while I was doing this bit was to, on the green screen, I'm running water in the background, but I just did a short little test. I tested it and it looks a bit daft with the rest of the else. If I had a massive green screen, it might have looked okay. So that went out the window. Okay then, right, let's go get a ropper. Jump shot. Okay then, right, as I said, I'm going to do some fancy editing because it's quite dark in here. I'll adjust the camera when I'm needed, but this is like just your first bit. You've got two little compartments on either side of this bag. I know you can't see them on this angle, but they're like a rubbery compartment and they're to put your oars in, and you can strap your oars up if you're walking about with it, but we've already discussed that, haven't we? Right, that's connected, so this thing is like a super strong as well kayak. It's not a cheap inflatable and it's rated, you can use it in the sea, you can go whitewater rafting with it, you can basically do anything with it.
But well, that's before I've even blown it up. I already know it's going to be fun getting this back in the bag. That's why I'm definitely recording this so I can watch it back so I know how to put it away. Alright, not too bad. Yeah, the back's all padded and everything, which you'd expect if you're going to be carrying it on your back. Just drop that down, and I know you can't see it now, so I'll adjust the camera. Just hold this bag. Something you should know, you also have, I know you can't see me, you also have proper foot pegs with this, like you would in a professional style area. And I mention that now because they're on top, they're really strong. I'll show you more of a close-up when I can. This is more of a just getting stuff out video and letting you have a look when it's put out. Oh, there's another bag here. Oh, big bag of instructions, and I'll show you a close-up of that in a minute. Let's just do one thing at a time. That's the seat. Trying to figure out which is the back. There's the seat. That's the back. Because I want that this way, because you fill it with air from the back and the top, but well, that's nearly under me. Jesus. I'll give you a long view of that. See if I can, don't go anywhere. Alright, I'm editing this in with my phone. And as you can see from one end of the room, all the way to the end where I'd set the camera up. And it's not completely flat there, as you can see, so there's some bloody size to it. And change action. Change action. I think I meant change cameras. That's the seat, we'll come back to that. Because of the position, yes, I know I'm not always going to be in shot, but we know it's not about me. I understand why they tell you to do this for the first time. Right, I need a rest. Don't forget, I'm not as young as I used to be. Not like anybody is. I'll show you what I'm doing here more once it's inflated. There's plenty of padding in this thing. Right, let's go back to the phone cam.
In the back here, you've got, that's for a sad, that's for the other sad, that's for the base, and then you've got one, two for the top. Air tanks to fill. Okay, they're the air tanks. Now, apparently the second time out is easier because the boat's more used to its size, shape I should say, which makes sense. So let's start, let's get the air pump, jump shot. Whoops. Right, inside the kayak itself, them three chambers I just showed you at the back. Well, included the two on the top, all five really, but they've got like a little button in, and you push it and it goes in and out basically. You push it and you have them out, which I know sounds weird, but you have them out, connect your pump on, and then you inflate it. And you have it, when you're finished, you put like a lid on afterwards, a cap. When you're finished, all you do is take that cap off and push the button in, and that blasts all the air out. Now apparently it comes out at one hell of a speed, the air. So don't have your head over it if you decide to get one of these. Okay, let's... I've left my phone on, it's taking pictures. Because I give it the keyword. Alright, let's bend the camera down again, and you start with the floor, the base. So let's start with that, get the chambers, and it'll start to take shape. Let's just get this camera tilted down again. I'll probably have to do a lot of jump shots with this. Right. Okay then. I won't be surprised if that bloody battery runs out. And yeah, left my bloody camera running. Okay then. Right. First chamber is the floor, which is that one. Little cap. Oh, there's the button. I wonder if I can get a shot of that for you on my phone again. Start recording. Oops. I've just took this cap off, but on there, and you can see that little button, and you literally just push it. Now it's in, now it's out. And the out position is what you want for inflating, which you'd think they would have made that the other way around. But you want it out for inflating. Let's get on with it. Oh, that pump. That is. I hope that's not shot. Either I've done something wrong. Well, that's the... Yeah, it must be going in because it's starting to hold more of a shape. But this pump, I thought I'd done something wrong. I hope this is, I have to check if this is in shot. Because this pump, yeah, this pump is so, two fingers. Yeah, The poles were so easy to use. Just checking my settings. Yeah, it's on number two, so. And the boat's going up because it's starting to take a bit of shape. Okay, I've come back in here because I wanted to, well, tell you this bit actually. The floor took me about 6 or 7 minutes, the base, about 6 or 7 minutes to actually inflate. Took us a while. I've done that side panel and it took me about 60 seconds. So this one I haven't started yet. I thought I'd show you how easy the sides are. So it's only the actual base that takes a while. You can see it coming up from there. Nearly there. Done. So the sides take no time at all. Just putting that little cap on I mentioned. Yeah. So what this is here, this is for you to store stuff in, going camping or whatever. You basically put whatever you want in, roll it up, fasten it all up, and it's all waterproof. But obviously I ain't got nothing in there. So yeah, so the base takes about 10 to 15 minutes. Right. The sides, nothing at all. And these tops, I reckon, that's in the out position. These are your tops. You've got a strong rubber seal running round. I don't know if you see on that angle. I have to adjust the camera again, sorry. You've got a strong rubber seal running around the cockpit, and that's for your spray skirt. You know them things that pull over and fasten you in, so to speak. Right, it's the same with this top one and this front one, 10 psi. Let's watch that one. Done. Okay then, right, this is your back, carry bag, so to speak, your back chamber. There's loads of room in there, you've already seen in there, right? Now here, your floor, it's rigid. It's rubber, but it's, this thing is solid. Even the sides are solid, you know what I mean? Well, I may have to do some fancy editing because the battery on that camera was dead when I just looked, so I don't know how much it got. I know it got some, but I don't know how much. Right, the seat. It's one of them things you have to touch it to understand. It's squishy, so it'll be comfortable, but God, is it solid. It's such a solid, dense piece of foam, it really is. And I know this is going to be comfy as hell. There your slot, that's what I was just talking about, which hopefully you'll catch. And they slot into the sides, where you've just seen the little notches. Can't get this wrong, because slots in. Now this back piece goes out underneath like that, so it doesn't interfere. I know it's full of air, but it's not full of helium, but it feels a lot lighter than what it did not long ago. And apart from the foot pegs, which I can't really show you, but basically, I'll tell you what. Whoa. All it is, you've got these two foot pegs. Now that piece underneath that I showed you, you slide it along and you strap it in place on the edge where I've showed you. I can't really get a camera in there to show, it's just, there's no room in this little hallway, you get me? But you slide them in, you put the straps around, lock them in with them buckles that you saw running along the side. And that's the best I can say. Right, it's show you a bit more in a sec. It's just, I feel so I've just stood in it now. I'll tilt the camera down so you can see what the hell I'm doing. That should be enough once I'm in. Right, yeah. This is so just, you see my other inflatable, you stand and you sink. But that's just like standing on a solid floor. It really is. Oops, don't forget we're not on the water. Oh, that's something else. Whoa, loads of leg room for me. That's something else. In my other inflatable, I could never get in a quite comfy position and I was always wobbling a bit. Right? And what I tried to do is put my hands on the side and push myself back in the seat. Well, the problem was there was the plastic on the inflatable just used to sink it into the water and water would come flooding in. Whereas this, as you can see, it's solid. This thing is solid. And where's my phone? You have to see this. You have to see this. Not my legs. Right, but that. There's just so much room for me to move about, you know what I mean? And like, reckon, they're them straps where you put the footrest, the foot pegs on there. Right. But, don't know if you'll see there, bit dark. But yeah, there's just so much room. Yeah, I'm a bit, what I could really do is pad this up. I've got an idea. Just while we're talking, I've got an idea. Drone bag. Two drone bags. That works. But yeah, I can understand why they've give you foot pegs. Because that, you see, like there, just being able to do that without sinking. So I know when I'm on the water, I'll be able to just adjust myself if I need to. I should really have my life jacket on to get the full, which I'll do that later, but just for me to get the feel before I put my foot pegs in. But yeah, so the foot pegs I can understand because my legs, because there's so much room, my legs don't know what to do with themselves. If I just leave them down flat in the middle, it doesn't feel like it feels a bit, well, it feels uncomfortable. If I have them bent up, yeah, that's fine, that's comfy, that's actually comfortable. But I don't want to paddle like this. So once the foot pegs are in, you've got something you can imagine, something to just get them in the right place, just rest your feet against. Say, for me, holding my legs in place would be about roughly there. That would be comfy, but because they're not there at the moment, my feet are just swimming. But yeah, so solids, I mean, this ain't fake editing, this is solid. This bit, sorry, This bit here will be loose, and obviously, because if you've got one of them, which I have, which I should try, actually, I'm not getting on, it's a spray skirt. You've seen them. It like wraps around your belly, it goes around, goes at the back. So if you're in the sea and there's water splashing all over the place, right, or if the water, you know what I mean, you know what it's for. Right, but yeah, it just clips over. So that has to have a bit of give so that you can pull it a bit to get it all to fit. In the front, you can already see, and if you can't, okay, back to here. You've got some meshing for, well, whatever you want actually, probably a bilge pump, right, just in case. This cover here, which looks like material, once again, this top part is rubber, and these cutouts for it, so you could get a bag on top and have some sort of strap to hold it in place. Decathlon do sell a special bag, designed for this. What's the point? I've got bags coming out my kazoo, so no need. But yeah, and you can't go in there, you, whatever you want. You got loads of space under there. You don't want to put too much heavy stuff in the bowl though. I mean, that would be a mistake, having too much heavy stuff. You can put plenty of heavy stuff in the back, right? I mean, it's rated up to 125 kilograms altogether. Well, I'm about 80 kilograms, roughly. So I could fit a 10, couple of bags, bits and bits. I could fit everything I'd ever need in the back. And you can put stuff in the front as well. You could put a bag up in the front. It's just a case of don't overdo it for the front. You know what I mean? Because the front bends up slightly and you don't want too much pressure on it. Okay, now, before I tell you about the underneath, because there is something to tell you about this that's very important, so I hope you're still watching. But before I tell you about the bottom, the hull, I'll let my friend George tell you a little story. I can't get over how strong this base is. Okay, George, tell them the story.
Okay, I'll tell them.
Hello, boys and girls. Are you sitting comfortably? Good, then I'll begin. Once upon a time, in a village called Decathlon, the people folk decided they wanted to build a kayak that was as strong and as fast and as manoeuvrable as a professional hard shell kayak. Well, after years and years of research and getting some of the best engineers in the world to help work on it, they come up and finished the X500. And everybody rejoiced. It looked amazing, but was it any good? So they got some professional kayakers out, and the professionals were super impressed. They said, it's amazing, it shoots through the water, shoots through the sea, shoots through the river, turns real easy. You've done it. You've made an inflatable kayak that runs as good as a hard shell one. Well, everybody in the village cheered, and they had a wild party, and straight away they put this wonderful, amazing kayak for sale. And then the dark clouds came. People started to complain. They couldn't sit in the thing. They'd stop for a second, they'd be paddling, stop for a second to take a picture, and they'd be in the water. You could not sit in it. They hadn't tested it with an average paddler. They'd only tested it with professionals
who basically just keep going. Whereas a recreational paddler would paddle down, stop, take a photo, do a vlog, eat a sandwich and just float. Well, the problem is, because of the way they're designed, the X500 was like a bullet, and it if you stopped, you just fell in the water. You couldn't sit up with it. So you couldn't move. So it was perfect for going in a straight line or sharp turns if you was in white water, but you couldn't just sit. So the townsfolk started to cry and they stopped. However, there was one person who said, no, we're going to keep going, we're going to redesign it. And that's what they did. George, how did they redesign it?
Oh yeah, George, you didn't have to shout.
Anyway, so, how did they redesign it? Let's take a look. Well, the entire kayak was like this all the way along. A nice sharp edge cutting through the water. And that's where the problem is. But this is where they've redesigned it. From here, running all the way along, all the way to this part. They've flattened it out. They've given it a flatter belly. I'm sure you can see that. They've actually flattened it in the centre of the kayak. So now, when you're sitting on it, if you're floating to take your photographs or eat your sandwich or pick your nose, you're fine. You're not just going to flip over. It'd take a hell of a lot to flip it. But yeah, right, well, we're here then. You can see here, all you'd think it was, I don't know, you'd think it was resin or summer or plastic, but all this is like a rubber seal. Right, well, this is a bit you would drag if you were dragging your kayak up onto rocks or something. Right, but you got a big rubber seal, and you have to remember, this is an inflatable. You can easily forget that this is an inflatable. It's so strong. You've got side straps, one there, and obviously two on the other side. There's your name there, Itiwit, or whatever you want to call it. Yeah, and this is a lovely boat. All the way down, all the way here, look, it's all, this is solid. And it's an inflatable. I keep having to say that because it's so difficult to believe. So you'd have a handle here, and if you're pulling it up, that rubber seal I showed you underneath a minute ago, you can pull it up onto a few rocks or whatever. They say you could basically drag it on anything, but you don't. You use your brain. You're not going to drag it across glass or nails. Or you know, you have to remember, it's still an inflatable. Okay, right. I don't really think there's anything else I can say about this now. I've tried to cover as much as I can. I also like the colour, there you go. I will show you in here, right? Because I didn't, just so you can see just how big this area is. You have got a lot. Them drone bags down there, I could fit both of them in there, no problem. You have got a lot of room in there, a hell of a lot. And it goes all the way up to the back of the seat. So you're thinking, from the back of the seat, you're talking about 6 foot of room. Well, I suppose you could forget this bit, but at least 4 foot of room. So there's loads of room in there, and that's a waterproof seal when you fold it over properly, not how I just had it. So there you go then. I'll just finish like this if I can. Hope you enjoyed this video, and the next one, you've already guessed, I'll be taking them out on the water for a maiden paddle.
Okay then, rat fans. There'll be, if any kids watch this, or anybody under the age of 30, you'll say, oh, the hell's Roland Rat? Look him up. Super famous in the late 70s, early 80s. Roland Rat. Right, I'll catch you on the river in the next video. Cheers.